ओके सो दिस न्यूमेरिकल इज एक्चुअली मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी डिसेंबर 2019 न्यूमेरिकल. ओके सो देयर इज द वन व्हाट इज द न्यूमेरिकल. ओके वी गो थ्रू पास दैट. देयर आर सेवन जॉब ईच ऑफ विच हैज प्रोसेसिंग ऑन मशीन ए एंड ऑन मशीन बी. ओके देयर ऑर्डर यू नीड टू मेंटेन लाइक फर्स्ट यू नीड टू सप्लाई ऑन मशीन ए देन ओनली यू कैन गो फॉर द मशीन बी. दैट इज द वन कंडीशन. The processing time is in hour. Find the optimal sequence in which the job are processed. So the minimize the total elapsed time, or you can say elapsed means the use time. Okay, from starting to end for address all this job. And the next point you can say when I talk about the optimize means you need to reduce the idle time. Okay, so that we need to do in this particular numerical. So now. What you need to do when this type of the thing will become in your exam. The first means, again I am telling you, the last session there we discussed regarding to the one machine only. Here two machine are given, okay, A and B, and with respective you need to manage everything like that. Your elapsed time should be means elapsed means the actual time needed to address all this job 1 to 7. That is nothing but the elapsed time and their idle time you need to calculate. Okay, so first what we need to do, the first we need to prepare the process timetable for the job and the two machine that already given in this numerical, and generally that will be given. Okay, so just from my side suggestion is like that, convert this horizontal table into the vertical table so we can easily visualize what is actually going on. Okay, the first process, convert this particular problem into the vertical table so you can easily visualize. Okay, I try to zoom this particular thing so it is visible to all. Just wait. Now it is visible to all class, this particular table.
Yes sir.
Okay, the thing is just simple, just I convert this all the thing, the job 1 to 7 in vertical form with respective what is the time needed for address the job A on machine, means address the job 1 on machine A, that is the 3. So I given here 3 hours, then that machining I need to do on the B, that is the 8 hours, then like that. Okay, for each process I just written. So I just quickly check it is right or not. Okay, 15 10 6 6 10 12 10 12 11 1 and 9 3. Okay so now I convert into the vertical table. Now what is the process to allocate the job. Okay, what job I will do first, so my elapsed time or will be minimized, as well as you can say the ideal time will be reduced. What I need to do, so as per the there is the one rule, that is the actually Johnson rule, or Johnson given that particular rule. First make one array as per the job available. Okay, make one array, or you can say the one block. Okay, so I try to make that particular thing. Just wait 1 minute. Okay, so I just try to draw the array of I think 7 block is there. Okay, so 7 block array I try to make here, and how to do that particular thing that we will discuss. Okay, so just make one block. Okay, big block, and there 7 division is needed because 7 job is given. Okay, that actually means we are doing the sequencing of this job, means when we need to pass a particular job and what is the sequence is required, so we can reduce the total elapsed time, or you can say the idle time. So how much actually here the total is 7. Okay, so I try to make, this is the block 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, 7 actually I need to reduce, right? Just wait. Okay. So now this particular block, once we filled up, then it shows the sequence, the optimal sequence. Okay. So I try to, I just written here that is the optimal sequence एक ओके इफ देर आर स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक देन प्लीज ट्राई टू मीन्स अंडरस्टैंड ओके देर मे बी द स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक ओके नाउ आई गो हाउ टू एलोकेट ऑल दिस थिंग द अलोकेशन प्रोसेस इज वेरी वेरी सिंपल एज पर दिस रूल फर्स्ट यू नीड टू चेक इन दिस एंटायर टेबल वॉट इज द मिनिमम आवर मिनिमम प्रोसेसिंग टाइम इन दिस एंटायर टेबल कैन यू टेल मी क्लास वॉट इज द मिनिमम प्रोसेसिंग टाइम वॉट इज द मिनिमम प्रोसेसिंग टाइम इन दिस एंटायर ओके द मशीन ए मशीन बी कंसिडर ऑल द थिंग एंड लेट मी नो वॉट इज द मिनिमम प्रोसेसिंग टाइम वन दैट इज नॉट आवर दैट इज द नोमेनक्लेचर ऑफ द जॉब ओके दिस इज वन आवर ओके आई एम सॉरी दिस इज वन आवर राइट दिस वन आवर यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ओके सो वॉट यू नीड टू डू फर्स्ट एलोकेट दिस वन आवर दिस वन आवर यू नीड टू एलोकेट ओके सो आई नीड टू सेलेक्ट दिस पर्टिकुलर जॉब सिक्स सो टिक मार्क हियर आई विल सेलेक्ट दिस जॉब सिक्स ओके आई विल चेंज द कलर जस्ट वेट सो देर इज नो वन वन मिनट आई विल चेंज द कलर ओके सो नाउ ओके सो वन आई टेकन ओके बिकॉज दिस इज द मिनिमम प्रोसेसिंग टाइम ओके सो जस्ट चेक आफ्टर दैट इट इज मीन्स इन राइट हैंडेड साइड और इट इज इन लेफ्ट हैंडेड साइड राइट हैंडेड साइड मीन्स बी और इट इज फ्रॉम ए इट इज एक्चुअली फ्रॉम बी सो वैन द मिनिमम वैल्यू इज बिलोंग्स टू द राइट हैंडेड साइड देन यू विल बी ड्रॉ हियर यू विल राइट दैट पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटी इन राइट हैंडेड साइड ओके आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट क्लास This is the actually optimal sequence. Then write down this is the minimum number which is belong to the right hand side or belong to the machine B. In that condition, you need to write that particular activity in right hand side in this block. Is there any doubt how to allocate this means job 6 in this you can say the optimal sequence array class? Actually, this is 6. I'm sorry. Just wait. Small mistake. This is the six job six. Is there any doubt, class?
No, sir.
Okay. So now you need not consider this particular thing. Okay. Assume that this is not available. This job is not available. And again, try to search which is the minimum processing time in this table. What is three? Okay, so there three and three are the two three means there is the actually tied up, right? Here also three available, here also three available. In that case, you need to check the corresponding row means corresponding the another machine time. Like here three and another machine time is 8. Here when I talk about the three, another machine time is 9. The what is the minimum means corresponding machine time? The minimum corresponding time is the 8. Okay. So I need to consider that one first. Are you getting my point? When the tied up between the this machine time duration, when allocating the optimal sequence, in that case you need to check the corresponding value. If corresponding value is minimum, that you need to allocate first. This 8 is minimum compared to 9. So I will allocate the job one first in this optimal array, optimal sequence array. Are you getting my point? Are you getting my point why I am not allocating the 7 is and I am allocating the 1? Class? Again, I am telling you the minimum number is the 3, right? The minimum number 3 here also available. Now, corresponding value you need to check. Here corresponding value is 8 on another machine, here 9. So, you need to select the minimum wala. Okay, so the minimum is the 8, so I will select the job 1 first. Are you getting my point, class? Class, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what I will be do, the job 1 I assign first, okay? And now assume this is the cross, okay? This is not available in table, just assume that. And now, I will go, this is the minimum next one and I will assign this one and this is actually belong to the right handed side and you can say the machine B in the second machine. So, I will allocate this in the right handed side of this optimal queue. So, here I will write the 7. Is there any doubt? Class?
No, sir.
Okay, so just let me know which is the minimum number. Just let me know which is the minimum number in this table class. Class, just find out
six.
The six. Okay, so again the six is the tied up. Okay, so what we will do for this four, when the tied up condition is occur, like here also six, here also six. So what I will be do, it is means I will put in the this optimal sequence in the left hand side or right hand side. So first I always preference I will give in the left hand side. Okay, so I will allocate that 4 also in this optimal queue array, and that one is the 4 I allocated here. Okay, so please try to understand, when the two number are the equal, in that case you need to give first preference to the left hand side. Okay, so now 4 is also completed. Assume that particular row is deleted in this particular table. Now go and let me know what is the minimum number in the remaining table.
10.
Okay, 10 again tied up. So which one I will consider? I think 10. Okay, so which one I will consider? The tied up between these 2 and 3. Okay, so which one I will first consider? Class, just I revise, corresponding value you need to check. Okay, so here corresponding value is 12 and here the corresponding value is 15. So what I will be select the first? What I will be select? 2. Very good. Why? Because the corresponding value is less. Now the point is, this is related to left hand side, you can say right hand side, I am sorry. So it is related to B. So in that case, where I will be write that particular thing here. Okay, so this is the 2, because it is belongs to the machine B, so I written here. So cross this particular thing. Now in available, what is the minimum class? Again 10, right? 10 here also available, I'm sorry. So again, actually 10 is the 3 in that case. Okay, and we selected this one. Okay, now I will select this one, this corresponding is less, so that's why. So I will allocate the 5 here, the remaining you will allocate in the 3. Okay, so is there any doubt, class, how to do the optimal sequence of the machining? Is there any doubt? This is the one rule, okay, given by the Johnson. Is there any doubt regarding to that? Any doubt, then please let me know. Because this optimal sequence will decide your numerical, okay. On the basis of that, we will calculate the everything. So this optimal sequence calculation is very, very critical part, okay. So now I start to draw the one table to find out the elapsed time, okay. So this is the one table already I prepared. Just I need to zoom that particular table. Just wait. It will be 24. Okay. Okay. So again, okay, so everything is given here. Now, as per the sequence, this is the sequence you need to put here in this particular table. That is the optimal sequence, right? The 1, 4, 5, 3, 2, 7, 6, right? Okay, so now this particular sequence I will use to reduce the idle time, or to reduce the elapsed time of for addressing all this job. So now, one is in optimal sequence is the first job I will do. After that I will do the fourth job. After that I will do the fifth job. After that I will do the third. After that I will do the second. After that I will do 7. After that I will do 6. Okay, so now assume that I started my process, okay, in my industry or in my plant. I started the process, and first I pass this job 1 in the machine A. has started. Okay, so when I will be pass at a zero time, assume that at a zero time I pass inside. Okay, I'm just type here so it will be clear. Okay, when it will be out class, when it will be out, I pass that particular job one on the machine A, when it will be out from machine A. Class, simple calculation, I pass, what is the processing time on machine A? 3. When I will be passed to the machine B, that particular job A, when I will be passed? At 3, very good. Okay, and when it will be out?
11.
11, okay, very good, very good. 8 plus 3 is equal to 11. So idle time, okay, I just want to know what is the idle time. What is the idle time? So here I started my machine 0 to 3, okay, I am not worrying about the machine A. Why? That you will be understand when we proceed further. But when I talk about this machine B, when I can use the machine B after 3 hours only, after 3 hours only, because the processing is going on in the machine A, then only we can pass to the. So 3 hours is the waste, right? Are you agree with me on the machine B? The machine B in the idle condition for 3 hours. Are you agree with me, class?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I will take the job 4. So when I can pass the job 4 on the machine A? When I can pass? At a 3? Because at a 3, it will be free. Machine A is free, right? Are you agree with me? Class, yes, at a 3 is out now, so machine is free. Now at 3, I will pass the job 4. And when will be out that job 4? At a 9, right? 6 is the processing time, so at a 9 it will be out. Are you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, when I will be pass this job 4 into the machine B? Please tell me.
Nine.
Actually, the work is going on till 11. How we can pass 3 to 11? There means processing is going on for job one, right? So when I can pass? Class 10th level problem. Yes, 11. Okay. So when it will be out? When it will be out?
17.
17, very good. What is the idle time? What is the idle time? There is no idle time. Because till 11, the machine B is working, and on 11, I will pass the 4. So there is no idle time. Please try to understand. If there any doubt, you can ask me. Now, I will pass my job 5. When I can pass the job 5 on machine A? At a 9? Because after 9 hours, it will be free, right? Are you agree with me, class?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so when it will be out? Because 10 hours is the needed, on 19 it will be out, right? So when I will pass that to machine B? When I can pass?
19.
Very good. And when it will be out? 19 plus 12. 31, right? On 19 I will insert the 12 hour is the processing time. So 19 plus 12 is equal to 31. And now can you tell me what is the idle time? What is the idle time? Just try to understand. This is the 17. On 17 hour my machine B is free. So 17, and when I will pass that job 5 on 19. So there is the 2 hour delay, right? 2 hour is the gap. So 2 hour, my machine in idle condition, machine B. I'm talking about the machine B. I'm rewriting here, okay? And I will discuss why I'm not taking the machine. Machine B idle time, okay? Are you agree with me? Class?
Yes.
Okay, yes, okay, just tell me for next one, 3. Four, three. 19. 19, okay, very good. Now, when it will be out? 19 plus 15. 34, right? Are you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I will insert that on 34 time. So when it will be out? In the machine B. Just check the job 3. 34 plus 10 is 44. What is the idle time? What is the idle time? Please tell me that particular thing. What is the idle time on machine B?
3.
Very good, very good. Now, I'm talking about the job 2. Okay, job 2, when I will be pass the job 2 on 34?
Okay.
When it will be go out? 34 plus 12, 46. Right?
46.
Okay, good. And when I can insert that particular in a machine B?
46.
Okay. And when it will be out? 56?
50.
Okay, good. So what is the idle time?
2.
Okay, now 7. For 7, just let me know what is the insert time. 46, okay. And what is the out time?
55,
okay. What is the in time?
56,
very good. Because on 56 it will be free, okay, machine B. And what is the out time?
59,
good. So what is the idle time?
No idle time.
Very good. Now, 6. For 6, what is the in? 55, right? And what is the out?
66,
okay. And what is the in time?
66.
66, okay. Because on 66 only that A machine will free that job 6, right? And what will be the out?
67,
okay. And what is the idle time?
7,
okay. So now we completed, means now almost our numerical is completed. What is the total idle time? The first question, I go to the here. The processing time in our given, find the optimal sequence. That optimal sequence already be calculated in which the job are to be processed. So minimize the total elapsed time. What is the total time required to address all this job 1 to 7? The total elapsed time is nothing but this time. This is 67. The total time needed to address all the 7 job. Okay, so that is nothing but the total elapsed time. And what is the total idle, or you can say the total idle time? Total idle time, can you add all these things quickly, class? 3 plus 2 is 5 and 17. So 17 hour is the idle time. And why I am not considering the machine A in the idle time? Because you know that the machine A is continuously working, okay? 0, 3, 3, 9, 9, 19, 19, 34, 34, 46, 46, 55, 55, 66. So it is not free. So there we know that in machine A, idle time is the 0. Always the idle time will be occur in the machine B. Okay? So in machine B, idle time is the 17 hour. So is there any doubt regarding to this numerical? This is the 10 marks numerical in December 19. Okay, 10 marks, just you need to identify the optimal sequence and need to identify what is the elapsed time. Very easy numerical. Is there any doubt regarding to this numerical, class?
No, sir.
So okay, this is the actually two sequence means when the job and job is available and the two machine in my plant, then how I will be managed by using this particular strategy, I can manage the entire thing. Okay, so this is about the end job two machine. In the next lecture we will discuss about the end job three machine. Okay, so before that I will check another numerical is available in the university exam or not. Just wait.